Monta Hoopla is set to tour America for the first time in 45 years. I'm John Bowden from Rock History Music. The tour will include, of course, their lead singer, the flamboyant Ian Hunter, and guitarist Ariel Bender, who hasn't been really in the band officially since 1974's The Hoople album, which, by the way, was their highest charting in North America. Bender did provide bonus tracks for the re-release of All the Young Dudes. He was also on their 1974 live album. This new version of Mott the Hoople will also include keyboardist Morgan Fisher, who was first on the Mott album from 73, and then became an official member of the band in 1974 with that album again, The Hoople. He stayed on with that group even after Ian Hunter left in the mid-70s to go solo, when they rebranded as simply Mott. It's kind of cool, the first tour in 45 years, and really this is kind of a tip of the hat to that album that was released 45 years ago, The Hoople, 1974. Appropriately, they're calling this tour Mott the Hoople 74, because Bender hasn't been in the fold since that album. He actually replaced Mick Ralphs, but went on to form Bad Company. Hunter said in a statement, "I know many people were disappointed with neither Bender or Fisher appearing in the 2009 and 2013 get-togethers. Hope this makes up for it." The 8-city tour begins in April in Milwaukee and wraps up April 10th in New York. Even though there were a lot of album tracks played in North America, Mott the Hoople were really much bigger in their native England, with top 40 hits including All the Way from Memphis, Roll Away the Stone, The Golden Age of Rock and Roll, Foxy Foxy, among others, and their only North American hit, All the Young Dudes, which was written and produced by David Bowie. As mentioned, they did have those reunions, specifically that 2009 period, tipping the hat to All the Young Dudes drummer Dale Griffin, who was at that point suffering from early onset Alzheimer's. In fact, he couldn't play the whole show. He only came on for the encore. He died in 2016. Bassist Pete Overton-Watts died in 2017. And guitarist Mick Ralphs suffered a stroke in 2016 and has been out of commission ever since. Joining Hunter, Bender, and Fisher in this North American tour will be James Mastro on guitar, saxophone, and mandolin, Steve Hawley on drums and backing vocals, Mark Bosch on guitar, Paul Page on bass, and Dennis DeBrisi on keyboards and backing vocals. I only saw Ian Hunter once in concert, and he was there with Mick Ronson, who also played in Mott the Hoople for a time with him and did a lot of stuff solo with him. You might know Mick Ronson from his work with David Bowie, Bob Dylan, Lou Reed, among others. A fabulous guitarist who we lost in 1993. But it was an amazing show. I remember thinking, wow, they should get Mott the Hoople back together. And I'll say this every time. I love reunions. Hey, we're approaching slowly. Within the month, we'll reach 30,000 subscribers on our channel. That means an awful lot to us. The dropout rate for people doing this sort of thing is incredibly high because the money's not that good. But we plan on chugging along because we enjoy doing this. Make sure you subscribe to our channel. And hey, have you seen Ian Hunter or Mott the Hoople in concert? Especially my friends from across the pond in England, where everything really got started. Share your thoughts and memories and what your favorite songs are. I love it when you give me your first impressions, you know, when I first heard this band, or more than people who just say, "Hey, Mott the Hoople suck." You know, I don't get that. So remember, subscribe to our channel, share our videos, and comment on them as well. I'm John Bowden from Rock History Music.